Okay, I'm back. At long last. Okay, so I'm tempted to, instead of really working, to start thinking about, should I? So I'm not actually going to code that, but I want to start thinking about this. How do I work on the music? In my idealistic world, I want the music to be auto-generated based on the game itself. So based on what is happening in the level, perhaps in the background or whatever, I want the game to generate a soundtrack. And if I want to push things more, maybe as you move, maybe there's an instrument that follows your movements and plays music according to whatever you're doing. This could be interesting. Where... how you play could influence the music. So how do I do that? First of all, what is nice with this game is that there's already a rhythm, so the puzzle has its own rhythm. I don't need to use it. Like those beats as locations where there has to be a note, but the rhythm could influence the music. Like this one is very steady rhythm. Oops, kind of fast for that. Yeah. So based on what I'm getting, like based on each level, I want the music to do to represent a bit what we're gonna be seeing on the screen. Slow. Yeah. So, music generation. How does that work? How do we generate music? So the way I want it to work. It's gonna be this black box. And it's this generates music. I don't know how it works, but I know that it generates music, so. Sound buffer. Yeah, that would work. So something is passed into the box. And then what output I get is like a sound stream or whatever it is, but like, but it outputs something, or rather it outputs music. Yeah, it outputs music or some sound. Also, is the idea that it outputs music? So do I consider this the music as separate? Oops, separate from the sound effect. So does the sound of dying? Does it still play this dying sound? Do my clicks play a sound? So are they, do I still have the concept of a sound effect? Or is everything mixed together into a soundtrack? Are sound effects incorporated in the music? Probably not. So there is a difference between music and sound effects. Oh no, those are not the sound effects I plan to use. They were made in 2 seconds. They're very loud, yeah. Oh, sorry, actually. That's a side effect of, I forgot to lower the sound system volume on my stream. So now it should already be better. But I can modify this, the volume, in-game too. Or in my code, rather. So now it should already sound better on your end. So for me, it's still as loud. But for you, it should be easier. Or I mean, it's probably still loud, but it's not as loud. Yeah, I lowered the music. Just because a lot of people don't like when the music is too loud and I speak and then they hear the music over my voice. So I guess I sort of, so music planning. So, something happened. And also, music is something that happens over time. Yeah. Also, if you end a level... So like right now, this music has like a rhythm. The rhythm is 1 second. So every 1 second, it loops. Oops. So let's say I'm hearing some music right now that syncs with the level. And then I switch to the next level. Now there's a different rhythm, which is now 400 milliseconds. So should the music end? Or should it keep going, but using the new rhythm now? I guess it does. It should keep going. It doesn't need to stay sounding similar, but it should like... It shouldn't like end and then a new thing starts. Okay, so I'm not thinking about sound effects anymore, because sound effects are going to be like hard-coded. Okay, so something goes in, some parameter, whatever, and based on those parameters, generate some music. And music is something that happens over time. So given like a timeline, something like there can be some notes. And I know that one measure can be so a measure would be the factor of the level's full time. So for each level, I know what is the amount of time or the loop time of a level. So I know that this level is 1,000 milliseconds, so 1 second. This one here lasts 2 seconds. This one here is 3.5 seconds. This one is here is 6 seconds and 600. 4 seconds, 2.8. With some stuff happening. Interesting. This here is 2.5 seconds. So it doesn't need... Okay. So I have this concept of a measure, a bit like in music. Let's go check. Could have sworn I had some music sheets on my computer. I guess just not on this computer. Kind of odd, but let's go find some. What, the guy quit? I quit, is that real? It's too much work. Oh, okay, never mind, that guy is a troll. Okay, never mind, whatever. Let's forget that happened. Yeah, I'm gonna go find a sheet music. This website is nice. Let's look at what music looks like. Really nice. Okay. Battle. So music has some sort of tempo, and then there are notes. So how do I incorporate this in my game? And then there's also, okay, well, this is like not required, but there's also like something going on, like notes that are there to accompany. And I think I'm allowed to play this on stream, so let's go hear that. I already know this song because obviously I heard it before, but let's mute that. So let's listen to that. Oops, I kind of should unmute. I don't actually know where we are because I wasn't looking. Let's listen. Never mind. Dun, dun, dun. Oops. It would be nice if my algorithm generated stuff like that. Let's play that again. Also, another question that is getting raised with this. Should people hear the same music? So if my music is all auto-generated somehow, and it fits with the level, so what you see is what you hear. And then you start the game and you see this level. Should you hear the same music as everyone else? Or is the experience different just because the music is auto-generated, so it can generate anything? Or should the algorithm generate the same music if I gave it the same factors? Interesting. Oops. And then let's say I beat the level faster. So, I mean, let's say I stay here an hour. So the music plays something that goes with this for an hour. And then eventually I beat it. And then the music starts to change into whatever this is. Now, is this like a new start, or does it keep going from whatever this was? So if someone beats this in like 2 seconds, then the music ends up different than if I waited an hour on this level. Also, I can't guarantee that the player is going to finish the level. At the right interval. So what if the player ends the level here? There's still all this. So do I finish playing this measure and then start the next music? Or does it start to the next music right away? Anyway, so I'll have to think about that. Let's keep going. I forgot where we were. Interesting. Let's find another one. Oops. Like that one. very cool. So, is the algorithm going to be like this, where I say some sort of like request music, like request measure? So essentially I tell you, I say, okay, let's start. Then I say, okay, I want one bar. So generate some notes for one bar right now. So, and I give it like, how long is one bar? Maybe 1,000 milliseconds. So essentially, instead of generating the music in real time, I ask the music in the future about generating something like this. And then the next loop, I request the next one. And then the next one. But I also want to have like some sort of continuity. So I don't want every measure to forget about what just happened. Like, let's say I'm generating this measure right here. Like, I want this to fit with whatever was there before. So the music class, whatever is happening, whatever is generating my music, needs to remember what it just did, and what it did also in the past. Okay. So I have this big thing. And this does... However this works, I don't know, but it generates music. Or rather, it doesn't generate music at all. So a music thing... Obviously music, what is music? Music has like some tempo or some rhythm. Let's. I don't know if there's a rhythm. The difference rhythm. Is that how you write it? So there's some rhythm. Music is made from like notes over time. So notes are played at specific times. So now I have this idea of a note time. Which is within my interval of... Rhythm, notes. Are notes already too specific? Maybe there's no such thing as a note. Because at the end of the day, I want my music to have some sort of personality. So every instrument, or an instrument. Or a voice.
Pregnant for the third time. Your will not hurt. I taste the maggot in the mouth.
Music. So music, what is music? There's a structure to music. I can't write. So something is happening in here, because like just looking at this without even, like, even if you don't know how to read music, it's easy to see that this is going to sound pretty good. Just because the way the notes are done, you can see that's like I'm building, something is getting built. Like you start to analyze just the visual shape of whatever is here. Like this thing shows you a lot of what is going on. Here there's the concept of playing a single note at a time, while here there's two notes. Why is there two notes here and not here? Is this like a new voice? Or can two notes be part of a single instrument? Or yeah, so maybe instrument is not the right concept for this. Here, like there's the long note, so this note alone takes the whole measure. So is this considered another entity? Another entity than those that are playing? So is this like someone else playing up there? And someone here playing down there? And then a third guy right down here playing whatever they want? Like right here, there's something going on right there. And then right here. Here they're all playing together. Here some are playing together, and then there's this loner right there that plays. Or is this here considered one guy? Since this is essentially the same note. But played an octave lower, higher. Well, here there's a third guy getting added. But you can argue that the third guy is part of those other notes. Let's say I listen to this. Actually. So let's say I listen to that. Oops. So this is the new champion in League of Legends. So when I listen to this, I hear a lot of different instruments. And they're all doing their own little thing. So obviously when they play, they're playing, it's playing fine together. But you can hear there's a lot of stuff going on. Like it's not just one little song. There's a lot of little elements. They're all working together to make one big masterpiece. And I can hear there's like some sort of clarinet. And it's like the lead. I think this is a saxophone right now. And the other guys, like the there's a bass playing. Like a lot of the instruments are there, but they, like, their contribution is really minimal compared to the saxophone, which I think is a saxophone, but so the music is really measured. So that works really well with what I want to do. Hey, Kanan. That's interesting. Then you can hear it end. So what is music? What are some attributes, rather? How are you doing? I'm guessing you already knew, but I'm making a game, and it would be nice if my game could have auto-generated music. So an algorithm that would generate music that would fit with my levels. Because in my game, I could foresee that I create perhaps 300 levels. Like, imagine if my game has 300 levels, and like, this game feels a whole lot better if the music syncs with the what is happening. So if this thing does, like, it goes at the same, I mean, I think it sounds harder than it actually is. So you see, like, imagine if you watch this and then the music would fit. Like, this puzzle has a rhythm to it. So I just need to play music with this rhythm. And like, this music would be pretty nice if I could, like, get this sort of style into my game. Oops. And right now I'm not really thinking about how to make sound, but more about how to generate something that can then be used later to generate sound. So essentially, this is like a world. Like the levels, they are in a physical location on a planet. So on this planet, you have levels that are laid around. So it would be nice if the music was there to immerse you into the world. So you play this game and you feel like you're actually there. So I mean, you can see the what is going on visually, but if the music is there to also make you realize what's going on musically. Oops. No, missed it. And it's really good. Oh, I stopped. Like some levels, they can be really complex. And if there's music that syncs with it, then it's really cool. What is that? I didn't hear that music yet. Elemental Flux. Yeah. Like, I don't want the game to feel disconnected from itself. Yeah. Like, a blind person could play the game. No, maybe not, but... Like, do I want music like this? I don't know. Like, I don't want the music to take all of the attention. Like, obviously in this game, the most important part is the actual puzzles and the levels and whatever. So like, this thing is the most important. Really? Wow. But like, my game requires click accuracy, so unless you know the game by heart, if you get a new level, you probably can't beat it if you're blindfolded. So like, in this world, like, those levels are really important. So I don't want the music to be taking all the focus, but I want the music to be there and to be part of this level. Really? Wow. The same thing for the world. Like, this puzzle has a physical location. So in this world, the idea is that the game is happening on this planet with a massive volcano. So while there's some sort of lore where the idea is that you don't want the volcano to kill everyone and like spill lava all over the planet, because obviously like this big of a volcano it would kill everyone. So your job in this world, along with like 1,000 other people that have the same job, is to solve those levels and allow everyone else to afford a really nice life around the volcano. So as long as the volcano doesn't kill everyone, everyone has a really nice life. So your job is to beat those levels and save the world. But I mean, obviously the world is not going to end if you lose, because you can assume that a lot of other people are also playing the game and solving. Or not really playing the game, but like everyone in this world, like there's the elite class of everyone that are able to solve the puzzles. Anyway, so while there is like this sort of big concept of the volcano and everything, if you want to play the game and not have to think about it, I think that's fine. So I don't want this idea to be just staying in the blindfold discussion. A blind person would need a different way of sensing the environment of the game. Yeah, that's true. Also, do I eventually need to allow people to play the game without music? Like, maybe some people, they'd rather listen to their own music. So do I need to make a way where you can just get the the basic sound information, but not really the music? Or is that, like, too hardcore? Or maybe there's only the rhythm getting played, and not the actual instrument? Or do I want to force everyone that plays my game to listen to my music? I mean, most games, they don't really give you the choice. It's either like on or off. Yeah. But like, is it SFX volume? So let's say there's a music playing, and it gives you some sort of cues about complex music. Yeah, exactly. So like no sound, just like the beats themselves, or the music with the beats and everything. Or is there a way to generate music that sounds good with other music? So let's say there's two music playing. Is there something that I can generate that works with other music? Okay, like, so now, let's say I listen to this. Like, this is Elementalix, Lux, and Ivern, and then I play them together. So now I'm playing the two together, I think. Oops. Thank you. Does that sound good, or is that like all everything's mixed together? This one is like war. This one is very friendly. Yeah, so this is arguably bad. Interesting. So does rhythm, like this sort of beat, can that sound good if there's another music playing that doesn't necessarily fit with the game? It's kind of hard to tell. So does it make sense to have some bass music, or do I just have either on or off? When it's off, you also have the option to just have the beats. Like this game without beats, how does that sound? Let's say I mute the game. Okay, no more sound. Okay, well. I mean, I can play the game, but is this a type of game where it's, you don't really stop the music? Well, it doesn't really count because at this point I kind of hear the sound in my head. Yeah, I hear the same thing as if I hadn't even stopped the sound. Huh. Interesting. Okay. So rhythm. So rhythm is only like an input. Dynamic. For example, I'm playing with a rhythm. In 2004, Game Freelancer, one of the best bass sim emo. There is a unique mission in which you take part in a race through ring-like satellites in space, partly through an asteroid belt. While not originally in rhythm, someone wrote a mod in order to create a track with rings, gates were placed. Yeah, you can link. Okay, so a rhythm, I think, is part of my inputs. I think that's an input. So the music is generated based on a rhythm as an input. So in the game, this syncs with everything that's happening. Okay. Okay, so right there. Okay. So at the core, the only input I need is the rhythm. And then the instruments, how do I define? I see. So for all purposes, it's similar to my game, where everything that's happening, I know what's going to happen in the future. Like, what is happening here is always looping. Okay. Let's erase all that. Okay, so music. What is music? In the context of this game, music is like so soft. Was it always this soft? No, it wasn't. Yeah, so this music in specific was really low. Okay. So music is like a class. It's something that stays. So it doesn't just get created, then used, and then removed. This is something that is persistent. The music class. But what I'm going to be asking it is, I give you this rhythm. I give you a rhythm. And then you're gonna output something. What is a rhythm, by the way? Rhythm. Yeah. Well, the way I'm thinking about music is this. So this is the eventual, I'm going for this sort of look for my game, where you're in this forest, you're a sort of alien creature, and then you're trying to beat it. And then based on where you are, or rather based on what is on the screen, everything could be used as a parameter or as a voice. Yeah. So let's say there's a big tree in the screen. Or two big trees. Maybe the sound of a tree in my game. Maybe it's a very low cello, maybe. Or let's go check my music. Okay. Alright. So maybe the sound of a tree on this screen. Let's remove that. Is the contrabasson. So maybe when you see a tree, you hear some sort of music composed with So the thing doesn't define what are the notes played, but maybe it defines like, so you see this big tree, you have like this drum, drum, da-dum, da-dum, So the composition of what you see visually, I think, where did I put my, did I already close that? I closed the image already? Wow, that was fast. Oops. So yeah, based on what you see, I think it's everything in the screen is an actor for the music. So as long as there's a tree in this view, maybe there's a part of the music with this. Yeah, and then maybe there is, maybe you're in a cave, and then cave sounds, maybe they are played by a certain instrument. Let's see. What are my instruments? Let's say when you're in a cave, you have like, I don't know, a basin. Okay, maybe not. So maybe if you're in a forest, this is a, like the core sound of the forest. And then, is there like... Yeah, exactly, something that is very long, very slow. Or some wind. Anyway, so the idea is that what you see on the screen influences or adds certain voices to the music. From certain. So if there's this bird, maybe you're gonna start hearing some flutes. And then maybe in the music there's some flute playing. So I don't care what it plays, but it plays something that fits with the music, with this instrument. And I sort of hear this a lot in the... And maybe like if there's on the screen some mushrooms, maybe the mushrooms, they have a... some sort of magical sound effect, maybe little oboes. Yeah. Like right now what I hear here, there's like the main thing. Yeah, themes could be biomes. So maybe mushrooms are like little tam-tams. Like the idea for my, what I'm trying to do is that eventually what you see on the screen, I sort of want it to be procedurally generated. So I create some assets, and then the game by itself places the assets. So like this is, so all that I want to do when I create a level is place the level's tiles, and everything else would be some assets that the game places by itself. Yeah. So maybe you won't notice it, but maybe if there's a bird, or maybe there's some butterflies flying around the screen, as long as they are on the screen, the music creates something that has the instrument that I picked for the butterflies. And then you change to the next level, and then maybe now there's no longer a tree, and then the music starts to adapt itself to the fact that there's no more trees. So the actor that was playing the instrument for the tree gets deleted or dies off. Like here I hear a lot of different instruments that are possibly just there to represent something. Like it's like everyone is trying to create music. Yeah, maybe objects that fade in and out. Or maybe there's gonna be... maybe there's gonna be some way to say goodbye. So the maybe the butterflies, or the little flies here, they start to leave the screen. Because we're going away. Maybe I send a signal to the other instrument that someone just left, and then they start to change, and then it's even more noticeable that someone left or the screen changed. Like you can hear some definite different identities in this music. Like there's obviously the main theme and everything plays and it all sounds good. But even if everything sounds good, everyone has their own little thing going on. So this is pretty interesting. And I want something like that too. Where overall there's a main music playing. And then some different instruments, they can join in on the fun. And maybe based on which race, so maybe there's more than one race of aliens on this planet. Maybe you can play as different races. And based on who you picked, maybe the music is completely different. Hey, Katsu. Looking good. Let's restart. I'm playing League music because I think League allows people to play music in their videos. So now something happened and now there's a big deep sound. Like it's very magical the way everything comes together. Almost done with school. Oh. Are you done this year or one final Monday, one final Tuesday? Wow. So done with school, you mean the session? So you have another session afterwards or Are you in high school? Or are you in college? I don't think I've ever listened to this music. Ah, then big break, nice. I'm also leaving soon. I think tomorrow I'm leaving and I'm coming. Can't even talk. There is a scene in a barber shop in which you break two different characters. Like, what I'm thinking about, I don't think has ever been done before. At least not the way I want it. So a lot of music is all, like, someone here spent maybe a few hours or maybe weeks just trying to get this music to sound right. And then you had to work with the musicians, and then every musician puts their input, and then the music becomes what it is. Really good music. But what I want is that my game, without having actual humans composing, I want the algorithm to do something similar to this. Okay, so there's this thing of a rhythm. What is a rhythm? It's weird that there's two H's in this word. A rhythm is something that tells me a time. So maybe something is happening at 0, 100, 200. Monkey. I'm guessing this is copyrighted, but let's try it. Like, a theme like this could easily be used in my game. Let's say the level has this rhythm. So like, and then the music can play on top of that. Okay, well, this part would be... So let's listen. Yeah, you see, so it's the same music, but you can have many different actors that change a bit the music. Like, it doesn't change it that it's not anymore the same thing. It's all the same. Like, there's a lot of little different sounds. And those other little sounds are not really important. But they are there. But even like if they were changed to different sound, the music would still be the same music. I can read their names. You can hear a bit their personality, I think. What type of character would this be? Playful character? Monkeys? If I listen to this now... Maybe someone that's fatter. Someone that is not as nice. Yeah, that one I figured, cause like even listening to this, you can hear how the music is like really weird and very perturb. How do you call it? Oops, wrong. Disturbed. Like this. You can already see that those characters are disturbed. And this is like a split personality. One is nice, one is the wolf. So there's rhythm, that's good. But there's also a general emotion. What is emotion? Emotion, what does that mean? Like with one rhythm, I can generate an infinity of music. Some are gonna like... Like, the rhythm itself doesn't tell you if the music is happy or if it's sad. Like, the Amumu song is really good here. Curse of the Sad Mummy. Wow, this one is way more popular than the... Like, do I need, for my game, for my music to feel like it's going somewhere? Even within a single level. So does the music need a purpose? So I stay here on this level for an hour. Does this music loop and sound similar over the whole hour? Or does it start to devolve and explore different ways, like even with this single flat rhythm. So you can have the idea of a core rhythm, so this thing here, which is like the important, and then you can have other rhythms with it. Interesting. Like, this is very sad.
Every child in Valoran has heard the tale before about the cursed mommy boy who felt his heart no more. So sad and lorn, the helpless lad, Amumu was his name. He ventured out to find a friend.
Go into your task manager and close League. If it's still there, then it's gonna fix it. Like, this is very hopeful music now. Yeah, I saw the wolf too, I was thinking. Zyra? No. Everyone's leaving him. Like, this is very hopeful music, even though it's sad. When I listen to this, it really feels like the video wasn't made with the music in mind. Determined. Like, there's a lot of things in the image that are not really represented in the...
Make friends if only they would understand. But even when Amumu stood upon the ledge of home, his hope would disappoint him.
Like, the video follows the music, but the music doesn't follow the video.
In his ear, it would confirm what was Amumu's biggest fear. It pledged that never shall someone become his friend. It pledged that he shall be alone until his end. Sorrow and despair. Too much to bear.
Yeah. Sad. Like, this part, it represents the tantrum ability. His ult, I think.
The moment when Amumu realized what he had done, too late it was for him, for them, the evil curse had won. The anger and the anguish overwhelmed his fragile soul and caused a wicked tantrum that he never could control.
OP. Oh, that's it? I didn't realize it ended like that.
Il ne te reste qu'à ramasser les dégâts, j'en ai aussi. Je connais ça.
So the emotion. Is the emotion an input to my music generator? Or is that something that the generator figures out by itself? Yeah. Use the tantrum on people. Great way to make friends. I'll be right back. Should the emotion change mid music? And how do you make music based on an emotion? Is that something I should think about, or should I let my generator compose music and then it knows it without actually knowing if it's happy or sad or It's already getting dark outside. Hey guys, check. I don't want to move my camera. There's so much rain outside. So, given a rhythm. Okay, so when I create my music class, or what is a music class? Like it needs something like a scale. What notes can I pick from? It needs some rhythm. What is rhythm though? Is that something that is enforced? I can't believe this is how you spell it. Yeah, I want to know how it feels. This word is so weird. Where does that come from? Oh, it's from the Greek. Rhythm. From Greek, any regular occurring emotion, symmetry. Generally, it's a movement marked by the regulated succession of strong and weak elements, or of the different condition. to several minutes or hours. A rhythm that could last for hours. Interesting. Many years. Rhythm. From Latin? And here it says from Greek. There's no mention of Latin in here. Rhythmus. Well, they say here it's from Greek. Rhythmus. Weird. Okay, so in Latin, rhythmus means movement in time. In Greek, it means measured flow or movement. Rhythm, proportion, symmetry, arrangement, order, form, shape, wise manner. So, disposition. Rain, to flow. Okay, so the rhythm is the flow. Yeah. Method of birth control attested. Yes, music style. From French, rythmique. Or directly from Latin, rhythmicus. From measured flow movement. What is that website? What did I never hear about that? Biorhythm. In the performance arts, rhythm is the timing of events on a human scale, of musical sounds and silences. So in my game, there's some sort of strong rhythms. Did I just do that? I did. Yeah. So this is a strong beat. So is rhythm different from the beats? Oops. And can all those instruments, like let's say there's a flock of butterflies and they're like flying over the screen. Do they have their own rhythms? And let's say there's a cloud passing by. Does the cloud have its own rhythm? Beating rhythm, interesting. And let's say there's a bird and there's a worm and the bird starts to eat the worm. Will you say that there's a rhythm to the time that the bird feeds itself? So every time the bird is starving, it eats. We can qualify this action as a rhythm. Is rhythm? What is the difference between a rhythm and a beat? Beat is the foundation of rhythm. It is steady, repeating pulse in music. When you tap your foot to music at a steady pace, you are tapping the beat. Crack. The verse I see only is one crack. In lesson one, you will have the opportunity to learn rhythm, perform rhythms that are all beat. Tempo is the speed of the beat. It indicates how fast or slow the beat is. Musicians use metronomes to practice rhythm. Yeah, sure. If you would like all this information in book format so that you can... Okay, so if I look at this... So what is playing right now is some jazz. Is there such a thing as a style? Do I need to think about a style? Is there such a thing as cinematic style? Or can everything sound cinematic, even like jazz? So does the fact that it's cinematic mean that it can be anything else at the same time while also being cinematic? Okay, so at the core, my music needs to use the rhythm of the level as a factor. And then I give you some arbitrary scale, and then I can say, do some music. Within this idea, how do I get different instruments to play together? Because I sort of want the different instruments to have their own personality. So while every instrument tries to play together, they also have their own personality. And when you think about the strong beats, the rhythm, there are some notes or some timings that are more important than others. Some are more important than others. But if you're not a main instrument, maybe you don't care. You just play when you want. As long as it sounds good with everyone else, then you're fine to play what you want. And you don't necessarily need to follow the main rhythm. So does it mean there's a main instrument that follows the levels or whatever's happening? But the other instruments, they also have their own rhythms? Or does that make the music sound chaotic, with no real goal or purpose? I wish I could listen to Ori and the Blind Forest music, but this one is like really copyrighted. This is no copyright song, so I guess I'm allowed to listen to that. Everyone's heard this before. So in other words, for the music to have a purpose, whatever's going on here is generating some sort of themes. A random level could have a chaotic ambient. Yeah, exactly. Final boss, then I pull. So as I'm generating music, I'm saving, I can just save each, and so there has to be the concept of a music database, maybe. Database. Where I save some sort of individual little themes, where you have like the concept of theme singular, and then so sometimes you want to create new themes and sometimes you want to reuse old themes. So in one way you have to store some theme. And sometimes you want to retrieve some theme and start reusing a theme. But just because you reuse a theme doesn't mean it has to sound the same. And do I need to be careful with what I generate? Are there some music that people are gonna hear and they're gonna say, oh, this doesn't fit with the game? So obviously there's gonna be some underlying rules. So based on some rules, so there's a layer of rules. And as long as you follow those rules, then you can say the music is part of the game. Yeah, so given some rules, so this is like the police, a sort of music police. So hard to write. I guess it's hard because my brush size is so big. So how does that work? What is a music police? Is it something that validates the music? So I generate some music and then the music police says, no, you're not allowed to do that? Or is the music police something that is fundamentally there at every step of the music generation? And if this is involved in every step, you end up with music that follows your rules. So do you want to have memorization, unique characters in your storyline lore? To be honest, I don't think I have... In my game, I don't think I have any real characters. Except for the player. Or players. So instead of having an actual well-defined story, I want the game to have instead a well-defined world. But I don't want to say what is there. Or rather, I don't want the story to be something that distracts you. And I don't think I want to have English or any language in this world. Yeah, some changes. So different biomes, for example. But I don't think I want to have, like, any real characters, except for whoever plays the game and their friends that are also playing the game. I want to make the game a bit like Planet Earth, the series. Where there's some dramatic, there are dramatic things that are going to happen. Let's look at this. Simulation games. Survival simulation game. Eyes in the sky, gazing far into the night. I raise my hand to the fire, but it's no use. Okay, there's a new version available. This is very outdated. Lost in Nature, survival simulation. Rip me. What happened? That happens to the best of us. Are there any animals there? Okay, let's say I look at the game, Let's say I look at a game like Don't Starve, where there's no... I guess this game does have a sort of story. But a lot of the gameplay is just like random things put on the map where like there's a tree There's a bird that can interact with you a bit. So there's no real story, but the game is fun for a lot of people anyway. This bird is so annoying. Like, I want my story to just be a background thing. So maybe the game at some point is going to decide that there's a big... maybe there's gonna be a tiger in the background. And then maybe a bit further away, maybe it puts a little rabbit. So maybe the tiger is coded to hunt the rabbit. So this is like a story. So while you play the game, if you want to stop and look at the background, maybe there's gonna be something happening. I don't know how repetitive it becomes, but like if all the different people and like all the different AIs have like some code and then they can interact with each other, that would be nice if that's the way the story is done. So it's not really a story, but it's more like a simulation of stuff happening, and that makes a story. So this makes you feel more like you're actually in this world. And you observe the life on that world. So there's not really a story, but there's like a general... There are like maybe just some AIs that live on the planet. And as you play the game, you can notice them living while you're playing the game. Like right there in this game. The game somehow generated a tree right there. And then you cut it, later it's gonna regrow. And then there's like this little bird that's flying. So it's not someone that coded the bird to be there, but there is some sort of algorithm that made a bird be there. Like right there, this one runs away. Well, in mine, I don't really want... Yeah, so you create an atmosphere. And then whatever happens is like the story. But I don't want it to be there to annoy you. Like, as you play the game, like I want the main focus to be the levels. But like all here, everything around there is like dead space. So I might as well use it for doing stuff. So maybe there's a river. And since there's a river here, maybe there's like, maybe you can stop and then observe this. And maybe you can see some fishes flying in this river. I don't know. And then maybe if there's a big tree, then maybe you can start to see some bugs. And like, those are like part of the... So like maybe the bugs are gonna be there living on this tree. And then if there's a bug, maybe at some point, like the fact that there's a bug, maybe it influences a spawn rate for birds. And maybe the bird stops, lands on the log, takes one of the little bugs and then flies away. And then maybe as the bird does that, maybe the music interacts with the fact that now there's a bird on here. The music starts to play some sort of bird music. And if there was only one bug, maybe now that the bug is gone, the music changes in reaction to now there's no more bug. So whatever instrument represented the bug now is destroyed or something. I don't know, like I want some like this to feel like you're in this nature world where interesting. Like, let's say I look at another game like Limbo. So I don't want the game to have a story and it's in your face. Oops. Give Give me a sec here. Capture the full screen game. For some reason it works now. Okay, give me a sec. Whatever I did makes it work, so I'm surprised. Anyways, so let's look at this game. Like, there's no story, but there's stuff going on. Like, you feel like you're in this world. You have all the background sound. This one doesn't have music, though. But indeed, there's a really great atmosphere, and then there's some flies. And the fact that there are flies means there's a fly sound effect. Oops, wrong button. Yeah. Oops. Can I jump over that? Yeah. I don't want to die. Oops. Oh, I caught it. Shit. I forgot how to, like, jump correctly. Yeah. Like, you can... There's some particles here, some light. And now we're in sort of a bit of a cave. The music's... Like, the sound changes. Or maybe it doesn't, I'm not sure actually. Oh shit. Then we start to hear some water going on. And this allows you to sell the world. I've played this game before, so I knew I was supposed to do something with that. Can I jump backwards? Oh, nice. Oh, close one. I wish I could just jump down, but I think this game kills you if you jump down. make it. I guess that's one other way of doing it, but like that's the headache way. Oh shit. Oh what? Oh! I did not expect that. I mean, I knew there was a spider there, but I forgot it reacted to me like that. Don't do it. Don't do it. Ah, shit. It just wants... Don't do it. That guy's, like, dangerous. The spider never happened, what? I don't know, but this is like the first real thing. It's like right at the start of the game. Oops. Do it. You know you want to. Do it, do it. Oh, got him. Next leg. Oh. Oh. Goal, progressing again while playing random games. Been down there. Exactly. No, but this isn't, like, important. Oh, got him. Like, you're playing this game and the world feels really big. But this game doesn't even bother to make music. And obviously worked really well for them. Shit. Don't do it. I think I'm stuck. Sorry. Like, there's no... Like, there's a story, but it doesn't really tell you what the story is in this game. Yeah, the silence is the music. So should I just go with no music? Is it better or should I put music in my game? The problem is that in my game, if you're bad, you might get stuck on a certain level for like 30 minutes. I guess it's the same for this game. Like, this is cool. Now you hear some frogs. Oh. Rip. I missed the jump. Again, shit. Sometimes it feels like the controls don't always respond. Oh, there you go. Push it. Oh. Wow. I don't think I've ever beaten this game. Oh shit, no. I mean, I know exactly what happens at the end and all, but did I ever play it all myself, or did I just, I don't know, watch my brother do it? Or... like, now there's the sound of the boulder rolling. That guy wants to catch me. I forgot what I'm supposed to do here. Oh, okay. Like, the game is fundamentally the same as when it started, but now there's like this little spider web stuck to my head. So it sort of gives a sense of progression. Oh. Really cool. Now I'm in the background instead of the foreground. Rip. Oh, got it. Wow, the power on this. Like, while you're playing this game, like, the world in there is real. It's really big. Pretty much all black and white graphics. Like, there's a lot of background stuff going on, which tells a story. But you don't actually know anything. Oh. Was there something down there? Can I go there? Oh, no. That thing is fighting. Survival of the fittest. Is that guy alive? No, alright. So, do I want some ambient sound in my game where you can hear water or... Oh, thanks. Am I going to have some scenes with rain, maybe? Where there's a possibility that the game has rain? Oh, rip. Don't walk on that. I kind of expected it. Smashed. Oh yeah, the power on those things is crazy. Wow. Tempted to end it here. Okay. Smashed. Yeah. Okay, so I already wrote a little algorithm to generate some music. Let's go listen to what it sounds like. So this is randomly generated music. I wonder why the sound is so low. Sure, whatever. So this music doesn't have any there's no really any team. Hey, Mr. Heesh. Why does it need to take all my attention? Wow, oh, crazy how many things it wants to show me. So what are the base guidelines? Essentially I'm saying, here's your scale, and you have so here's your scale, and then you have a certain amount of time to play something on that scale. And as long as you play on that scale, the melody and the chords are gonna sound good together. It used to sound better than that. I'm able to plug into it. I wish I could create a MIDI driver or something so that I could see the notes. Minor scale? I think this is minor. Let's try it. How did that work? I'm using a major minor scale. So right now it's playing on this. Oh. No, it's not. How does the notes for this are I think those are the notes. Because it's 0, 2, 4, 5, 7, 9, 11, 12. Okay. 0, 2, 4, 5, 7, 9, 11, 12. Yeah, exactly. Okay, so I'll plug it into a minor scale instead. Let's hear what it sounds like. Yeah. I wish I could raise the volume on that. So bad. Oh, it lagged. Oh, when I'm scrolling, it stops. Huh. It stops the program. Interesting. So, Microsoft MIDI Mapper device 1. Can I do that? I used to be able to plug the MIDI output 0, 1 into my other sounds so that it sounds better. So this thing right here. Is there a way for me to know if I'm actually using my sound fonts? Oops, wrong. Same. Wrong button again. Open mixer. Okay, this is not a real minor scale again. Actual minor scale would be this. Oops, errors. Oh, so maybe it wasn't minor scale. What is a minor scale? Let's go check. Yeah. Minor scale is 0. Oops. 2. Okay, that's a minor scale. Choose to use this. It sounds so bad. Did it just stop? It's not supposed to stop. I'm so annoyed at it. Sounds like I wanted to use this sound. MIDI file. I have that, but it doesn't work. I mean, it used to work, but I updated to Windows 10 and it stopped working at some point. It's so not fun to work with MIDI on Windows. Sure, do you want to continue? I already have it installed. I'm guessing there's some errors or something. Sorry for not like doing anything interesting, but it's like bugging me so hard. Maybe I can just uninstall it. Reinstall afterward. Thank you. October. I don't know if that fixed anything. I just reinstalled the same thing, I think. Oh! Actually, I think it did fix it. Now I can use virtual synth number 1. Device is 3. Oh, I did it. Whatever I just did, it works. Nice. So this is a minor. Yeah, whatever I was playing earlier was crap. Now it's not. I mean, it can be worked on, but at least the sound is good. Very sad. Like, you just want to go and hide in a corner if you listen to that. So now this music is just random, so there's no really any theme. It doesn't reuse, so everything that's played is forgotten right away. So that's why there's no real structure to this song. Yeah, exactly. Let's listen to a major instead. It's like someone's playing music for you, that's how it sounds like. But they don't really know what they're playing, but they're just playing.